You're listening to the BBM Global Network with 25 years in broadcast audio and video production. Our passionate team creates content and marketing for the world of Internet talk radio. If you've got a passion, come join us at bbmglobalnetwork.com. The BBM Global Network, your voice is now heard.
This is Nagel and Knowles. Everyone has the right to feel physically and psychologically safe in their workplace. The multidimensional team of Nagel and Knowles will discuss the process for helping organizations with this growing problem that we face in our society today. From a simple lack of respect in the workplace, to bullying, to extreme violence, Nagel and Knowles will create a more healthy and harmonious atmosphere. So now, please welcome Nagel and Knowles, your workplace violence prevention experts.
Good morning, everyone. You are listening live to Claire and Richard Knowles of Nagel and Knowles on the BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio this morning. We are pleased to have you join us as we discuss the comprehensive yet basic primer for preventing workplace violence. Reducing the risk of workplace violence from happening in your workplace is what Nagel and Knowles is all about. You can check us out at NagelKnowlesAndAssociates.com. We are full spectrum advisors in workplace violence prevention, and we have an intense desire to help workplaces reduce the risk of workplace violence.
If you think of the word primer, what comes to mind? The dictionary defines this word as a small book containing basic facts about a subject which you're interested in and use when you're beginning to learn about or have an interest in that subject. In the past few years, preventing workplace violence has become a phrase that is in the headlines, as we read everything from bullying and toxic workplaces to armed perpetrators who go into workplaces and do some bad stuff. Our primer for preventing workplace violence is getting better and better known as more and more people hear about workplace violence, especially when the catastrophic situation happens. At Nagel and Knowles, we know that it doesn't have to be that way, and it's the leaders in our organizations who must most need to have knowledge and to stand up to work and prevent workplace violence.
This morning, we're going to take you through that primer, a page-turner, if you will, as we review some of the main nuggets that you really do need to know and to do to reduce the risk of workplace violence in your own workplace. You know, since last October, our team at Nagel and Knowles has been broadcasting every Saturday morning about some aspect of workplace violence prevention. We've addressed the gamut. And if you listen to some of the show's titles, well, you'll see that they could be like chapter headings for a primer in reducing the risk of workplace violence. For example, here's just a few of them. Civility in the workplace. What you need to know and do to reduce your risks. The iceberg of ignorance. And how what you don't know can hurt you. Security-mindedness and active shooter protocol. Preventing sexual harassment.
And here are a few more show titles, especially when it deals with leadership. The Leader-Manager Difference. The Secret Sauce in Preventing Workplace Violence, which is leadership. Straight Talk. What is critical for leaders? The connection between leaders and workplace violence.
And there have been others, like these, that each connect in some way to reducing the risk of workplace violence in your workplace. Titles like these, Employee Engagement Matters, Lessons from Kindergarten, yes, Applying the Basics, Workplace Bullying and How to Stop It, Preventing Sexual Harassment and How That Fits with Anti-Violence Measures, and Risk Assessments, Doing Vulnerability Assessments, so that you know exactly where you stand. Last week's show, for example, was Taking Stock. Do you know how vulnerable your workplace is? From the inside or from the outside.
Speaking of primers, it's probably a good time to share this with our listening audience. We have a book for you which is free. It's a primer in its own right because it shares exactly what its title declares. It's called The Guide to Reducing the Risk of Workplace Violence, The Absolute Essentials. And it's free for you. Simply go to our NagelKnowlesAssociates.com website and scroll down to the comment box or the Contact Us section. Share your address where we should send your booklet. It's free. We pick up the postage. We just have to have a valid U.S. Postal Service address to send it to you. We're sure that once you've perused this primer, you'll want one for each member of your team. On pages 41 to 44, it will provide a comprehensive list of things organizations should do to reduce the risk of workplace violence, both from the inside cultural side and from the external facilities vulnerability side.
So we've noted this morning that this particular show is both comprehensive and a primer for reducing the risk of workplace violence. Comprehensive, meaning pretty complete, including all or nearly all the elements or aspects of something. In our case, it's about addressing the elements of workplace violence prevention. We would be remiss if we did not also mention that sprinkled throughout these shows over the last couple months, we have had some honored guests who have brought heightened levels of expertise. For example, in one show, Kathleen Bonzik, who is both an attorney and the founder of the Workplace Violence Prevention Institute, addressed school violence because schools are workplaces too. That show was so meaningful that we actually aired it twice. And as Kathleen noted, through the Workplace Violence Prevention Institute, it is clear that a grassroots movement is needed to stand up for our children, for all workers. It starts with awareness, transcends to education, moves into action, and also on a personal and local level. Each of us can do something to stop the tide of school violence. We also had the honor of having Michael S. D'Angelo, whose credentials include CPP, CSC, CHPA. Indeed, he's a board-certified security consultant, along with our partner, Robin Nagel, also security and leadership advisor focusing purely on the prevention of workplace violence. Well, together, the two of them shared the microphone on one of our Nagel Knowles shows. And they address the entire gamut of risk assessments, about what is all involved in doing the physical vulnerabilities assessment. And active shooter protocol took center stage. This particular broadcast was also repeated because it was so informative. As a primer, it is interesting to note about the type of reasons organizations give for not preparing. Like, oh, it won't happen here. Well, as this particular show emphasized, those are famous last words. Continuing on with the theme of primer and covering the comprehensiveness of what these broadcasts have been over the last 6 months or so, just let me lift up for you that if you go to the BBM Global Network, that's where you're listening right now, to the Nagel Knowles show, and scroll down about information about this show, you will come to the archives, a complete listing of all these broadcasts. And from there, you can download any or all of them that most appeal to your concern or area of interest within the realm of preventing workplace violence. They're all downloadable in MP3 format, and that's a good thing. You can listen up when it best works for you.
It's really important to get yourself fully informed and to begin to be comfortable to talk with your people about it. Lots of people are afraid they're going to cause some kind of a fear or disturbance or get the people upset in their organizations. People can handle the truth. Just talk straight. Don't overdo it, but let people know this is an important issue to be working on. We're coming up to a break soon. When we come back from the other side of the break, we'll be excavating the gems from many of the Nagel Knowles shows we have already done over the past few months. Each has its nuggets that you'll want to hear. We'll look at the comprehensive overview as well as the basics. And you don't want to miss any of these. Each show has its gemstones and touchstones for reducing the risk of workplace violence. It's so important to keep your head in the game, keep thinking about all the dimensions, all the way from creating a respectful workplace and having everyone treating each other with respect and care. You're listening live to the Nagel Knowles Show on the BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. We'll be right back.
French Rastafarian baker Chef Hugues Mott is a fourth-generation baker and has worked in 11 countries across three continents.
Born in Mulhouse, France, he began apprenticing in his father's bakery at age 12 and has devoted his life to learning cultures of the world from inside kitchens across the globe. He also teaches traditional French baking by hosting demonstrations and classes, and his passion for baking is reflected in his delicious confections. With a deep respect for discipline and his Rastafarian way of life, Chef Uvmat exemplifies commitment to tradition and culture in a global world. Traveling extensively and combining a myriad of flavors into his recipes, Chef Uvmat brings a unique approach to baking. To read more about the French Rastafarian baker, visit www.frenchchefugues.com. That's H-U-G-U-E-S. Bon appetit and bless up.
Master of words, powerful player. What life-changing words can Dr. Janet Smith Warfield pull out of her magical toolbox that just might mysteriously open a door you never knew was there? A door to free yourself from fear forever. Transform your rage into right action. Release your guilt. Position you into a life of freedom, purpose, passion, power, and peace. All quite suddenly, unexpectedly, and almost miraculously, with no effort on your part. Join Dr. Janet every Monday at noon Eastern on Dancing with Words, Dancing with Wisdom on the BBM Global Network as she and her guests show you how words map our experiences, immersing you in a sound bath that relaxes your muscles, opens your mind, and supports you in co-creating your extraordinary life.
Welcome back, everyone. You are listening live to the Nagel Knowles Show on the BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. Nagel and Knowles are your preferred source for comprehensive workplace violence prevention solutions. In today's broadcast, we are revisiting some of the best of the many broadcasts we've conducted over the last 6 months that have covered the spectrum. One of the most flavorful was a takeoff that we did around the lessons learned in kindergarten. As the rules from kindergarten, yes, kindergarten, transcend to our workplace interactions too, and point to ways to eliminate dysfunctional behaviors. Especially notable is this for HR managers as they create their code of conduct. For example, what would happen to bullying if we played fair? What would happen to vengeful acts in the workplace if we were watching out for others? And what would happen to sexual harassment if we kept our hands to ourselves? What would happen to incivilities if we said we are sorry if we hurt somebody? And what would happen to the need for active shooter protocols if, when we went into our workplaces, we were adept at looking for those who do not belong on that premises and who should not be there, meaning strangers? What would happen if the code of conduct for our workplaces included the requirement for a respectful workplace?
A lot of the ideas for this show came from a book Robert Fulghum wrote 25 years ago called All I Really Need to Know I Learned in Kindergarten. He offered some uncommon thoughts about some common things. His book has been quoted extensively because it's so basically profound. Would that we all could behave in the workplace using the same guidelines we learned way back then. Then respect would reign, and we'd be making huge steps toward reducing the risk of workplace violence. It all comes back to the interactions of people, whether we're 5 years old or whether we're just acting like five-year-olds.
It is important that HR managers especially take in the revelations stemming from the lessons from kindergarten and embrace them for creating the codes of conduct, the behaviors that you're seeking for your organization in order to reduce the spectrum of workplace violence. And here are some more of those. Play fair. Don't hit anyone. Keep your hands to yourself. Clean up your own mess. Don't take things that aren't yours. Say you're sorry when you hurt somebody. Share. Put things back where you found them. Take care of yourself. Take care of others. Take care of this place. Would that we all could follow these simple rules in our workplace. Then, as Richard said, respect would reign. And yes, the spectrum of workplace violence would be diminished.
Now let's turn our attention to a theme we've referred to often in our broadcasts, and that's the penny metaphor. It's a significant meaning in helping everyone to understand the entire spectrum of workplace violence. Because if you want to reduce workplace violence and the risks in the workplace, Your leaders have to understand the whole and the parts and how all these things are interacting together. These two sides of the penny metaphor describe Lincoln's face on one side of the penny, and that's indicative of the people and the psychological side of your organization. And the Lincoln Memorial Facility side of the penny is indicative of the safety and security side of your facility. Both sides need to be addressed when you're looking to reduce the risk of workplace violence occurring in your workplace. Next, and continuing with the metaphor, you can clearly see there is copper in the penny. It integrates both sides and is integral throughout. And that is the leadership component. That's the leadership effect in the workplace culture. Leadership shows up in practices like these. A level of engagement that is respectful. Having degrees of autonomy that people have. Enforcement of standards. Having a clarity of focus. Looking at the amount of collaboration that takes place and the cohesiveness. And looking at the communications and feedback. All are key to an organization's effectiveness. Leaders are just like the copper. They impact the whole enchilada, tying both sides of the penny together. In preventing workplace violence, Nagel and Knowles have the wherewithal to work with the whole penny, both the inside culture, the people side, and the facility's physical safety and security side, as well as the leadership component. It is who we are and what we do.
For us at Nagel and Knowles, we look very closely at leadership. And it doesn't take much to see when an organization lacks good leadership or when it needs leaders to become more effective, to step up and to step in. Working with leaders is our forte for addressing both sides of that penny metaphor. And that is why we have devoted over the last 6 months a half a dozen broadcasts to the importance of leadership in any organization. Because it is essential to thwart workplace violence, whether it is originating in the inside culture with dysfunctional behaviors, or whether it's coming externally with vulnerabilities to your facility. Effective leadership can be taught, and learning to authentically engage people is key to organizational success. We shared a story, it was a Facebook post, that noted that leaders are always on, meaning that people watch you all the time. When you're that leader, your presence is leadership. Your attentiveness is leadership. Your questions are leadership. Your participation is leadership. Your engagement is leadership. And even when you think no one is watching, you are leading. Indeed, being a leader and knowing that what you do or what you don't do makes a difference is important. It comes with accepting that yoke that comes with leadership. The worst thing that can happen is for you to think you're a leader, but you acquiesce on your responsibility to lead, because everyone can see that very quickly.
Being a leader is a key position, and the first thing you must do is to take a stand and be willing to be held accountable for that stand. Can you do that? That's the number one question. We've created a partner-centered leadership process that illustrates this, and here are some of the characteristics. You must take a stand like, we must treat each other with respect and learn together. We listen, talk with the people every day. We share information abundantly and respectfully. We're authentic and consistent in building trust and interdependence and helping people see how their work is important to the success of the whole. Decisions are made by the people at the correct level. The culture is safe for anyone to speak up, share information, ask questions to anyone, and make appropriate decisions related to their work. These are some of the aspects of what leaders must be doing, and it begins with taking a stand.
Real leadership is the essence of what is needed in our workplaces today, tomorrow, to reduce the risk of workplace violence. We teach leaders how to lead effectively, and we teach them processes to help their teams to move forward together, thwarting the dysfunctional behaviors that can be detrimental and helping the whole team to row in the same direction. So we'll soon be coming up on a break. When we come back from the other side, we'll excavate some more gems from our series of broadcasts about workplace violence prevention. Please stay tuned. We will be right back.
Tune into It's All About You with host Dr. Martha Latz, a lively weekly broadcast on BBM Global Network, one of the most empowering shows for time-starved, overscheduled multitaskers. The professional expertise of Dr. Latz is directly available live every Thursday at 1 p.m. to answer and address concerns about relationships, life transitions of career, meeting, dating, and committed relationships. It's All About You with Dr. Latz will expand your understanding of current concerns across your relationships by broadening and expanding possible solutions in developing skills for mutually desired outcomes. Dr. Martha's expertise is as a licensed marriage and family therapist, life, transition coach, and all things to do with communication at work, home, and with friends. Check out her website at auniquetherapycenter.com. If you're a person caring for someone living with dementia, then this program is for you. It's designed for families and friends coping with the challenges of caregiving. The foundation of care, Susan Kohler believes, is communication. Innovative Dementia Care with Susan Kohler provides strategies to keep the lines of communication open between you and your loved one, increase quality interactions, decrease the burden of daily care for you, the caregiver. Join Susan, 11 a.m. Eastern, on the BBM Global Network. Susan and her guests will share techniques so you can facilitate your loved one's ability to safely follow your instructions, participate in daily activities, and express daily wants and desires to learn positive solutions, creative ideas, and practical strategies that will build a healthy foundation of care.
Welcome back, everyone. You're listening to the Nagel Knowles Show, where collectively our work is focused at reducing the risk of workplace violence and eliminating the hostile, toxic environments that make people dread going to work and cause employers to wring their hands about what to do about it. Hopefully your workplace isn't one of these, but if it is, you've come to the right place. We're coming to you live on the BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. There are two shows that we broadcasted earlier that created a lot of positive spark, and we were asked to replay them. Both were interesting, and both had to do with the dysfunctional behaviors in the workplace. The two shows were Bullying and How to Stop It, and Preventing Sexual Harassment in the Workplace. Both hit a strong chord with our listening audience and clearly informed us that toxic behaviors in our workplaces are epidemic. There are over 2 million claims each year filed to the EEOC about bullying and sexual harassment. And so many leaders yet do not know how to step in and stop this mistreatment. This is a travesty, but we know how to do this. This is part of the work of Nagel and Knowles and our outreach.
To start with, leaders first need to know what the continuum is about toxic behaviors contributing to workplace violence. That is a key learning. So stay with me on this as I quickly connect the dots along this continuum. Because it starts with rudeness. Yes, rudeness. The kind of put-downs that if not called out or checked, as we say, well, that can lead to more. And that more manifests into the next level, incivilities, like disrespecting your person, your family, your work, etc. It shows up in the workplace in situations like backbiting, name-calling, eye-rolling, condescending words, tone of voice. And if those behaviors are not called out or checked, well, that behavior increases. And you can see why having and enforcing a code of conduct in your workplace is important. In the white-collar world, when these incivilities are not checked, well, then that begets unprofessionalism. And unprofessionalism becomes the norm. Alliances, gossiping, and undermining, and dismissing others' contributions, and all kinds of exclusions take hold. The workplace turns negative. And if it's not called out, then that just keeps on going. And when rudeness, incivilities, and unprofessionalism are not checked, well, then bullying begins. And when no one will stand up to that, it crosses into harassment, and then sexual harassment, and then into vengeful acts, like false dark rumors. Things like mobbing, shunning, keying a person's car, slashing a tire, cyber stalking, all these things done into one's face or behind one's back. It is a continuum. And it creeps like a cancer into the workplace a little bit at a time. And when you add it all up, what you have to deal with is indeed a toxic workplace, a hostile environment where people dread going to work and complain all the way home. Wonder why it is. Any other piece for leaders who are ignorant of the need to step in and stop it is that you have allowed the conditions to be created in your workplace, and you have allowed them to become the fodder for a homegrown active shooter. The person that says they've been bullied enough that they just can't stand it anymore and it's succumbed in some way to drastic, extreme, heinous, or revenge-type measures, well, we know it doesn't have to be that way.
Both OSHA and the EEOC tell us that these hostile environments, where toxic behaviors like bullying and harassment and sexual harassment persist, are unacceptable, and that employers must maintain a workplace that is psychologically safe as well as physically safe. The role of leaders is to step in, step up, and stop these toxic behaviors. We help leaders learn how to do this.
We've often heard the adage that bullying happens because it can. So this begs the question, well, who's allowing it to happen in your workplace so that it can? Do you know? The same holds true for sexual harassment. Who is allowing it to happen in your workplace so that it can happen? Who knows about it, but does nothing? You know, as we go around the country speaking and doing workshops in various businesses, there's a very clear theme. Leaders and HR managers and supervisors, they're searching for answers. They're seeking ways to have healthy, respectful, not hostile work environments. They understand the dysfunctional, toxic behaviors that permeate their workplace. And they know that they create the hostile environment, but they're not finding the leadership courage to get ahead of it and to put into place what is really needed.
Bullying is a dysfunctional behavior, as we've said, and it falls within the whole spectrum of workplace violence. It's an abusive behavior that, if it's not called out and checked, will escalate. That's why it's important that all employees, not just HR, not just supervisors, not just the managers, have a keen awareness of what's happening in the workplace. Specifically, we have our Stop It process for work groups to use to challenge the dysfunctional behaviors they may be plaguing them. We help teams and work groups learn how to use this process. We also have another process for leaders in their workplaces that can stop the dysfunctional behaviors quickly, if they want to. We love to share it and help to transform organizations, and it's meaningful for us to see leaders step up in a new way and a more effective way. Equally, it's rewarding for us to see whole work groups use the Stop It process and improve the whole team's well-being. It works. That's why we use it. If it appeals to you, by all means, please give us a call and we'll share more.
If sexual harassment is happening in your workplace, well, it's a safe bet that other forms like bullying and unprofessional behaviors are happening too. I'll venture that if you think about it and really look and listen about for what's going on in your workplace today, you'll know someone in your workplace right now who's always pushing the edges, from unwelcome touching, hugging gestures, mild transgressions, to pornography or worse. And when no one calls out the behavior, guess what? That behavior deepens. Given an inch, perpetrators will push for another inch and try to take the mile. So if you want to know what's happening in your workplace, we can quickly do what is called a cultural assessment. And then you'll know where you stand and where your gaps are and where you can begin to put your improvement efforts. You'll also determine why there is fear in your organization that is preventing people from speaking up and for leaders from stepping in. And those are key things to know.
We'll be the first to tell you that training in these arenas is key, but not just computer-based training, but real hands-on training. Reaching an understanding about what bullying is, who does it, why they do it, who sees it, and what individuals in groups can do about it. It's also about knowing the five different ways that sexual harassment shows up in the workplace, and what can be done in each of these areas. And the training addresses the basic fears people have for being singled out.
These dysfunctional behaviors do not need to be tolerated. We'll close this segment now with this key statement. You are empowered to stop it. When we come back, we'll be into a new segment. about vulnerability for your facility and active shooter protocol. Stay tuned. We will be right back.
Are you looking for employment and live in Los Angeles, Orange, Riverside, and San Bernardino counties? Jobs Annex is the place for you. Are you an employer looking to fill a position or quite a few positions in Los Angeles, Orange, Riverside, and San Bernardino counties? Jobs Annex is for you. Employers, JobsAnnex.com is your resource for career-minded people. JobsAnnex.com is the convenient place for job seekers and employers to hook up and move forward. Jobs Annex has been serving Los Angeles, Orange, Riverside, and San Bernardino counties for over 14 years. Jobs Annex is a former employment search firm. We've evaluated many thousands of resumes, and we understand what employers want and what job applicants need to be successful in their interviews. At Jobs Annex, we provide you with the tools to tell your story for free. Our resources at JobsAnnex.com will help each applicant construct an award-winning resume, an eye-catching cover letter, and key interview questions to ask in various types of interviews. Best of all, it's free. JobsAnnex.com. That's JobsAnnex.com.
Do you battle with weight loss? There is a solution. Founder of Weight No More Consulting, Deborah Simons, can help you lose weight safely and effectively through weight loss surgery. I know. I had the surgery 2 years ago, and I am 135 pounds lighter and medication-free. This full-service weight loss center caters to your every need as you navigate to a healthy weight following surgery. Servicing all of Canada, Weight No More Consulting takes pride in its compassionate care and guides you through each step before and after surgery. Starting with informational meetings, Weight No More Consulting educates each potential client before they decide to have surgery on the health risks of obesity and the various weight loss surgeries available. After surgery, Weight No More Consulting provides a solid support system with ongoing meetings to ensure continued success. Deborah Simons and Weight No More Consulting are committed to promoting your health and wellness through maintaining a healthy weight for life.
Welcome back, everyone. You're listening live to the Nagel Knowles broadcast on the BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. This morning, we're discussing a primer of the various aspects of preventing workplace violence. We're reviewing some of our standout broadcasts from the last 6 months and excavating some of the gems from these broadcasts. The work at Nagel and Knowles is all about reducing the risk of workplace violence, and this includes both the physical violence that can happen in a workplace as well as the psychological violence like bullying and harassment. In each of our segments this morning, we're drawing from the more than 24 shows, and we're lifting up the important things.
Several of our broadcasts have centered around how vulnerable people are in the workplace to violence, especially to the active shooter, and also that so many people need to know about situational awareness, being alert to what's happening around you. Being situationally aware can apply to the tragic side of things, like an active assailant entering your workplace to do harm, or to the language and gestures and dysfunctional behaviors that are happening around you in the workplace that add to the psychological hurt of a workplace. The spectrum of workplace violence envelops both the physical and the psychological. And we know that the term workplace violence is a comprehensive term, yet everyone who leads or manages inside a workplace or who works in an organization knows it when they see it and when they feel it, or as they cringe when they read tragic headlines and reflect upon, could it happen here? The it is workplace violence, ranging from incivilities to murder in the workplace.
The learnings for every person listening today is this. There are two important aspects to addressing your workplace security. One is from the inside. Are you home growing your own active shooters through a lack of respectful, effective workplace? Doing things like allowing incivilities to take place, like bullying, harassment, and vengeful acts? Do we have a lack of operating discipline and nobody cares? Or ineffective termination procedures that are cruel to those that have to leave? Another learning, of course, is how to harden a target where your physical facilities are located. How easy is it to get in? How do you leave? Are there hiding places? Are there checkpoints? What kind of deterrents are there? Are there ways to detect penetrations?
So where do you start to take stock to see how vulnerable your workplace is for workplace violence occurring? Well, there are two essentials that are important to complete. One, a physical vulnerabilities assessment. And two, a cultural inside assessment of your people and their interactions in the workplace from top to bottom. And both are quite doable in just a couple days. The assessments are your starting point. They will show you where you stand and pinpoint where and how you are most vulnerable. So how do you know your vulnerabilities if you haven't assessed them? And that is the question that you must answer.
At NagelKnowlesAndAssociates.com, we offer what's needed across the board for reducing the risk of workplace violence. Give us a call or engage someone else, but take the initiative and do something proactive. Your workplace security is at stake. And as we've noted, once you've done both the inside cultural and the physical facility asset assessments, you'll then know where the gaps are, and then you can prioritize them for addressing what is most useful and important. And you can create your plan and then work the plan. What we know is that you can have a respectful and civil workplace, and you can develop security awareness.
Our partner, our security expert, Robin Nagel, is often asked, is it really necessary to do active shooter training? Our answer is yes, and we add a caveat. We look at active shooter training as essential for a workplace because if something were to occur, it is much better to be able to respond with a trained response than an untrained response. And it is better to have your workforce be anxious but not panicked, be prepared and committed to act rather than be in denial and have a sense of hopelessness. We look at this training as a benefit, really as an HR type of benefit, because your people are not in your workplace 24 hours a day. They are out and about. They're in restaurants, theaters, churches, stadiums. And the learning from active shooter in the workplace training transcends to other areas of our lives. And we teach our children and our families and our friends to adapt to the same sort of awareness and readiness. The caveat is that the active shooter training should not be a standalone. Rather, the situational awareness training should be coupled with it. Situational awareness is a frame of mind in which you are relaxed, yet you're aware of your surroundings and are also aware of whom or what could be of help to you if a problem were to arise in that moment.
I'd like to inject something here that may be both interesting and helpful. I'm an Eagle Scout, having achieved that many years ago. And even back in 1948 in the Scout Field Book, there was this statement, as a scout, you should make it a point to see and observe more than the average person. They were trying to teach us about situational awareness even then. Training exercises and increasing one's observation skills were key to becoming a good scout then and now. So along with active shooter training, we think it's important to learn how to identify the threats and the dangerous situations. Situational awareness is the ability to identify, process, and comprehend information about how to assess and survive in an emergency situation. Nagel, Knowles & Associates incorporates that into our offerings.
If you go to our website and go down to the comment problem, you can, or comment box rather, you will come to the ability to have our free booklet, Guide to Reducing the Risk of Workplace Violence, which we discussed earlier. And you'll find 10 pages that are devoted to security-mindedness, situational awareness, and active shooter protocol. And this includes the directive that each of us needs to take an active role for our own safety. We see so many people today who are unaware, thoroughly engrossed in their devices, that they are oblivious to what is happening around them. Remember the Pokemon craze of a few years ago when people walked off curbs into caverns and into traffic because they were oblivious to their surroundings? Well, in the workplace, we have people who are what we call sleepwalking, oblivious to the situation around them. And it doesn't have to be that way. And we can teach you how to become aware of your surroundings and have a better chance of being able to react more swiftly and with decisive actions.
The Department of Homeland Security has outlined three courses of action to take during an active shooter incident. They are run, hide, or fight. Any one or a combination of these is essential to your survival. To freeze and do nothing, however, will only put you at further risk. Try to remain calm. Follow the actions of others if it's feasible. During an active shooter incident, your job is all about survival of yourself and those around you. Those who are trained and take immediate action will undoubtedly provide direction for all the other people.
We can't say it enough. A proactive and holistic approach to prevention is critical. So be vigilant. We will see you on the other side of an upcoming break. We'll be right back, so please do stay tuned.
French Rastafarian baker Chef Hugues Mott is a fourth-generation baker and has worked in 11 countries across three continents. Born in Mulhouse, France, he began apprenticing in his father's bakery at age 12 and has devoted his life to learning cultures of the world from inside kitchens across the globe. He also teaches traditional French baking by hosting demonstrations and classes, and his passion for baking is reflected in his delicious confections. With a deep respect for discipline and his Rastafarian way of life, Chef Hugues Mott exemplifies commitment to tradition and culture in a global world. Traveling extensively and combining a myriad of flavors into his recipes, Chef Hugues Mott brings a unique approach to baking. To read more about the French Rastafarian baker, visit www.frenchchefhugues.com. That's H-U-G-U-E-S. Bon appetit and bless up.
Did you know that your beliefs create your entire reality, but it's the subconscious beliefs that do most of the creating? Belief shifter and life coach Shiraz can help you identify those limiting beliefs and eliminate them, often in a single session.
Like, it was almost instant, like I had relief right away.
Creating better health, relationships, careers, and finances. Let Shiraz help you step out of safety and into awareness.
Definitely something's happening. It's like a flow inside. Yeah, it feels good.
Whether in person or online, Shiraz provides personal coaching, belief shifting. Visit Shiraz at energeticmagic.com or call 416-529-7429. Energetic Magic on the BBM Global Network, Tuesdays at 7 p.m. Eastern. Find your greater happiness. Be well. Be aware. Be magical.
Welcome back, everyone. You are listening to the Nagel Knowles Show on the BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. We are a collaborative, multidiscipline team of professionals who have focused all our efforts on reducing the risk of workplace violence. And I'm sure that you can tell we have a passion and enthusiasm for making a difference in the work world.
We at Nagel Knowles & Associates help our discerning clients with all aspects of preventing workplace violence. We're full spectrum advisors.
So why should you care about that? Well, this morning's show has hit upon several reasons for wanting to know more about having civility in the workplace, along with respect, as well as having a workplace that's entire workforce is security minded, trained on how to be situationally aware, and prepared in the case of an armed assailant entering your workplace.
So the answer to why should you care is simply this. It's all about you, your safety, your security, your being able to go into work without dreading it, your being able to come home from work to your family without being a statistic of workplace violence.
So we've shared the highlights from some of the broadcasts we've done across a variety of topics this morning, lifting up some key learnings, all having to do with preventing workplace violence from happening and from escalating and from becoming a tragic workplace. It is about caring about people, about yourself, about others, and about your workplace. Yes, we've lifted up some key learnings in each of the segments this morning, from a simple code of conduct to the importance of authentic leadership, from stopping bullying and sexual harassment to civility, from the inside to the outside of the penny metaphor, and from toxic behaviors to homegrowing a perpetrator, and from situational awareness to active shooter protocol. And we hope that you were listening.
So let's use this remaining time this morning to consider just a few words about a variety of ways to reduce workplace violence. Let's lift up some more learnings. If the workplace conflict is taking a toll on you, please take note. Culture is a set of living relationships working toward a shared goal. It's not something you are, it's something you do. It's how you interact with others, relate to others, connect to others, communicate with others in the workplace, and it extends from being healthy to being hostile. It doesn't take too long for a cultural harassment assessment. The results that emerge will quickly indicate which end of the spectrum your organization is in learning. Are you healthy or hostile? We're somewhere in between. What does your cultural barometer tell you?
And in the arena of human resources, there is a marked difference between compliance and achieving prevention of all forms of workplace violence, from incivilities, bullying, harassment, to vengeful behaviors, up to including homicide and negatively intended perpetrators. You know, organizations might have a policy and have done some training and think they're okay in compliance on paper. But what we know is that the prevention of bad behaviors like harassment and bullying is also about affecting culture and leadership, because we know that dysfunctional behaviors within a workplace increase if they're not checked. It is a continuum. So we can assess where your organization currently is and offer a full range of workplace violence prevention programs. That's up to you.
Let's talk about real leadership. Leaders are searching for answers. They're seeking ways to have a healthy and not hostile work environment. We know that leaders are responsible for ensuring that the workplace does not become a hostile workplace. OSHA laws make that clear. We know that a leader is not a real leader unless that leader is effective. Organizations that invest in effective leadership training hold their managers accountable, reap amazing rewards in the form of competitive advantage, employee engagement, cultural health, and reducing the risk of workplace violence. Supervisors at all levels are key to thwarting the spectrum of workplace violence. Effective leadership skills can be taught. When management is not taking the effective job, the workplace suffers. It doesn't have to be that way.
Training and development is an important base for organizations to stand on. And there is a key question that needs to be asked, and it goes like this. How would you like to be treated by your peers and by your managers? Because when it comes to training on prevention of workplace violence and reducing the risk of bad behaviors within your workplace, this becomes the key question. And the answers translate to your company values and in turn the need to reduce the gap of what an organization says they want their culture to be like and what it actually is. So I'll ask you again, the key question. How would you like to be treated by your peers and your managers? And now that's up to you. What is the gap between what you want and what is actually happening?
Think about security assessments and the personal situational awareness and the physical aspects of security protocols. We know that people are the number one asset in any organization. Since personal and facility security is an essential requirement, both morally and legally for businesses, we help leaders identify vulnerabilities across the full spectrum of the business. For example, to strengthen physical security measures like access control, visitor management systems, to understand where in your workplace you're most vulnerable, and then help formulate a plan to mitigate or eliminate the risk in the workplace. Protecting people and securing assets is another goal that we have here.
Let's talk some more about safety and organization and security. All organizations know that one of the keys to their success is safe operations, and that is ensuring that their people go home at the end of their shift in one piece, having their eyes, their ears, their limbs, and their life intact. Safety results are an aspect of culture, how it's led, enforced, taught, reinforced, expected, in the safe performance of task and the safe conditions of the environment, and in the engagement of employees in their own safety and those of the team. And as you can see, security fits like a glove here. The safety and security of a workplace are covered by OSHA and EEOC rules and regulations, as well as many state regulations. And we know this, that effective leaders do not ignore safety, nor do they ignore security, if they genuinely care about their people.
It's important that leaders don't sit around and wait for OSHA or the EEOC to show up. They need to be proactive, to step forward and stop it in the workplace. They are responsible for taking a stand and creating a safe, healthy workplace. And you can do this. This is not impossible. We all know how to do this.
As we think about one thing we want to make sure that you are thinking about in your workplace is how situationally aware are you? Are you walking around oblivious to people around you? What are your five senses telling you? What do you see, hear, smell? What can you taste? What can you touch? Those senses are important to develop. Those observation skills are key. So we are soon coming up on a break. You've been listening to Nagel and Knowles live, BBM Global Network, and TuneIn Radio. So when we come back, we're going to summarize all these nuggets for you. So stay tuned for more takeaways. We'll be right back.
If you seek a courageous advocate prepared to champion your rights with consumer service agencies that support aging populations, Carol Ann Hamilton is the one for you. Carol Ann is an elder care coach, author, and speaker with a 250,000 hours lived experience successfully supporting uncopable aging parents. As a result of a challenging journey, Carol Ann revolutionizes how stressed out caregivers restore serenity to their worlds. She also brings over 25 years of change management expertise in Fortune 500 settings to catalyze urgent transformation within the elder care industry. Carol Ann is a popular speaker at conferences across North America. She has appeared via TV, radio, and print globally. Now you can tune in weekly to get a dose of her inspiration, plus down-to-earth advice to cope with even the most difficult aging parents. Listen Wednesdays at 9 a.m. Eastern on Bold Brave Media and TuneIn Radio.
Introducing BetterHomeAndGarden.com. That's www.BetterHomeAndGarden.com with just the letter N in Better Home and Garden. BetterHomeAndGarden.com offers you the highest quality products on the market that are environmentally safe and effective, and to make them available to you at the lowest possible prices. BetterHomeAndGarden.com understands that kind of creativity and do-it-yourself attitude. Thus, we developed our website, BetterHomeAndGarden.com. BetterHomeAndGarden.com offers you the following products right online: bath, bedding, collectibles, craft, sewing and hobby, food and beverage, furniture, home decor, kitchen and dining, lamps and lighting, large appliances, musical instruments, outdoor cooking, patio items, pet supplies, plant and garden, rug and floor covering, small appliances, travel and luggage, and so much more. Better Home and Garden is an online retailer offering a wide variety of high-quality brand-name merchandise at discount prices. Our service is personal and we aim to please. Visit us at www.betterhomeandgarden.com. Make your home your own.
Welcome back, everyone. You're listening live to the BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. This is Richard and Claire Knowles broadcasting for Nagel and Knowles this morning, where our work is all about reducing the risks of workplace violence. We thank you for tuning in today and thinking deeply about some of the important touchstones that we've addressed this morning for preventing workplace violence.
Hopefully, you have some takeaways that you'll address in your own workplace. Our intent for this broadcast today was to provide you with some of the essentials you need to know and the things that would benefit by doing some of these things as you develop your comprehensive workplace violence prevention program and consider what is best for your organization and business.
If we truly believe that workplace violence in all its forms, from incivilities to bullying to harassment to eventual acts to murder, can be prevented, well, then we must be vocal and share how. And that's what we've been doing this morning and in our weekly Nagel Knowles shows. Just as a reminder, go to our website, Nagel Knowles & Associates, scroll down to the comment box, and share the address where you'd like us to send your free booklet, The Guide to Reducing the Risk of Workplace Violence. It's free, and we'll pick up the postage. And I just want to remind you that on pages 45 to about 48. In that thing, there is a complete list, a comprehensive checklist of what you need to know and do for both the cultural side and the security side of your organization.
We're big on leadership. Leaders are searching for answers. They're seeking for ways to have healthy, not hostile workplace environments. We at Nagel & Knowles show you how to do that. We have a passion for people, for safe workplaces, effective leadership, and respectful environments.
We know about security and active shooter protocol and situational awareness. We understand why awareness of one's surroundings is paramount and what to do in the critical moments.
We know that there are a host of ways regarding both the psychological, cultural side and the physical facility side of workplace violence that are effective for reducing the risks of violence. And we know how important solid leadership is to the entire process.
At Nagel and Knowles, we are adept at doing both cultural and vulnerability assessments, and then creating and rolling out success strategies for teams and organizations to move forward. And we shared some of those strategies with you today.
When asked, how does this all happen? How do we start? We always share that it starts by our listening to you. Yes, we'll start by listening to you, hear your story, your concerns, what's keeping you awake at night, what is it you'd like to really see have happen and how your workplace should be. And we'll lift up where essential improvements might be found, and then together quickly assess your culture, your facility vulnerabilities, and then go from there. There's a good reason why we are a preferred source of comprehensive workplace violence, because we know and what's going on and how to help you.
It is true. We're experienced and knowledgeable professionals. We know what we're doing. We're effective at what we do. And our approach is cost-effective. Before you call us, though, please do this. Peruse our website, NagelKnowlesAndAssociates.com. That's N-A-G-E-L-E. A-N-D is spelled out, NagelKnowlesAndAssociates.com. Check us out. Check out our LinkedIn profiles, too, and order up our 65-page booklet on the Guide to Reducing the Risk of Workplace Violence, The Absolute Essentials.
Then you'll truly understand the absolute essentials for keeping your workplace civil and your workplace fully security-minded. In the meantime, jot down our contact number, 716-622-6467, and give us a call. We mean it when we say that it's important to address the inside and outside of your workplace possibilities. Whatever you do, don't just sit around and wait. Enlist our help and give us a call. We truly understand how the absolute essentials for keeping your workplace civil and your workplace fully securely minded is important.
We're getting the signal. It's time to end today's show and sign off until next week. Till then, remember, be aware of what's happening around you. Your security depends on it. Thank you for listening. See you next week.
Listen each week for answers to all of your workplace violence concerns here on Nagel & Knowles. If you require help in your workplace setting, contact Nagel & Knowles at 716-622-6467 or log on to NagelKnowlesAndAssociates.com.
You've been listening to the BBM Global Network. The ideas, views, and opinions of this broadcast are those of the participants of the program and are not necessarily the ideas, views, and opinions of the BBM Global Network Company.